safe drinking water is scarce in many regions of Southeast Asia. In this video, we would like to show you how the VACUP project can help with groundwater contamination problems using efficient treatment plants in Vietnam. Rising sea levels and more extreme weather conditions, like tidal waves, leave groundwater and surface water with an increased salinization. Also, the groundwater in Vietnam shows high concentrations of arsenic, a highly poisonous substance, which is naturally washed out of sedimentary rocks. With the modular concept of VACUP, firstly, arsenic-laden groundwater is treated directly in the subsurface, and arsenic is mitigated. This is done with an in-situ remediation process called ZAR. We will take a look at this shortly. Secondly, the water is purified through capacitive deionization, or CDI, to remove salt and obtain drinking water. If the water is higher in salt concentration, for example with either ground or surface water in coastal regions, another pre-treatment must be added to the process called low-pressure reverse osmosis. By combining these two technologies here, the energy consumption can be reduced and better desalinization results are achieved. Groundwater contaminated with poisonous arsenic is treated with a simple yet effective method called ZAR, subsurface arsenic removal, right in the ground, where it naturally occurs. First, the groundwater is pumped to the surface and enriched with oxygen. It is then pumped straight back into the ground, where a natural oxidization process starts. The iron in the water precipitates, meaning it drops to the edges of the zone, taking with it dissolved arsenic. The arsenic particles are now bound to the iron oxides and are no longer harmful. Afterwards, the water from the clear water zone around the well is pumped up to a storage tank, giving us safe water to drink. And this is what a ZAR plant looks like. In this project, the VACUP team set up the equipment in direct neighbourhood to a Buddhist temple. Here, the groundwater is often contaminated by dangerous bacteria and viruses, since the community well is located very close to the sanitary facilities of the people who live there. Because each plant is adaptable to individual needs, it was not much of a problem to also install a UV lamp to get rid of critical bacteria. A second pilot plant was built in the Vietnamese province of Tra Vinh at the Mekong Delta. Here, the purified water is also used for fish breeding. Because the VACUP project takes into account sustainability and environmental aspects, the team used a photovoltaic and wind energy system on the roof. As there is a higher salt concentration in the water, the CDI technology, capacitive deionization, is applied after the ZAR process. Let's take a look at this purification technique, which takes place after the arsenic removal. In step one, the saline water flows between two porous electrodes. An electrical voltage is applied, forcing the dissolved ions towards the positive and negative sides, and out of the water. When the electrodes are fully charged, the voltage is reversed in step two to release the adsorbed ions into a concentrated brine. The VACUP team makes sure this unwanted waste stream is disposed of responsibly. In order to avoid that salts are reabsorbed during the regeneration step, ion exchange membranes are placed before each electrode. For the desalinization of surface water with even higher salinity, a third pilot plant was installed in the province of Khang Gia, at the delta of the Long Tao River. In these remote areas, no freshwater wells are available, so water is shipped from the mainland every week. The combination of CDI and low-pressure reverse osmosis will therefore provide safe drinking water for the population. Since the beginning of the VACUP project in 2016, significant results have been achieved. The project is managed by the University of Applied Sciences in Karlsruhe, Germany. Project coordinator is Professor Jan Hoinkes.
We are always concerned to involve final thesis students, and we started with a very outstanding bachelor student with our first pilot plant. So we always like to have this to show our students something practical, how to deal in the real environment, not only staying in the lab, so moving out into the world.
I was very lucky that I had really supportive people with me, and our local partners helped me really good with translations and to get technical equipment, and also the locals were very supportive and helped me where they could. It makes me proud to have participated in this project and to see that this technology really has the potential to create a big impact for the local people and create safe water.
We can show in a real environment that it works, that it's not the science for scientific purpose, it's science for everybody, so for the society.